ॐ गणानां त्वा गणपतिगं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्यवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनशृण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ओम् Dear friends, we are about to start this 22nd shloka. That is, Name Parthasti Kartavyam Trishuloketsu Kinchana Nana Vaptam Avaptavyam Vartayevacha Karmani. We read this shloka in the last class. I think I broadly explained the meaning. I will again tell the meaning. In the earlier shlokas, Arjuna was saying about how King Janaka and others, they attained samsiddhi, they attained the supreme goal by doing karma. It is not by abandoning karma, but by doing karma, they attained the supreme goal. So when we say by doing karma, they attained the supreme goal, it does not mean some jnana karma samuchaya. In spite of karma, we should take it as in spite of karma, because they were jnanis, they attained the supreme goal. And Shankaracharya presented two alternatives, that is, in case they were wise men, they attained, so that this karma was only some sort of appearance only, it is only a karma abhasa, it was not exactly a karma which will give them any fruit of that action. So that is how they attained moksha. And in case they were not, say, jnanis, they got chitta shuddhi, that is purification of mind through the process of this karma, and then they attained moksha by further action like Sravana, Manana and what not. So all those things we heard. And then Shankara Krishna also mentioned that a person, a jnani or whoever is an important person in society, he becomes a role model for others. Yadyad acharati shreshtaha tattade vetarojanaha. So he becomes a role model. He is the person whom all other people emulate in society. So in that context, he is also saying, he is drawing attention of Arjuna to his own example. So see, look at me, that is what he says, look at me, I don't have anything to do in all the three worlds. Name Parthasti Kartavyam Trishu Lokeshu Kinchana. Trishu Lokeshu means in all the three worlds, Name He Partha, Name Asti Kartavyam. There is no bounden duty for me. Kartavyam is something which is a person is bound to do, it's a bounden duty. There is no bounden duty for me in all these three worlds. Kinchana, anything, whatsoever. Then, na anavaptam avaptavyam. Na anavaptam means, there is nothing which I have not already obtained. That is, he is the Lord Himself. He is the avatara. And then there is nothing for Him which is yet to be obtained from outside. Na anavaptam avaptavyam, or something yet to be obtained. There is nothing which is not already obtained. There is nothing which I have to freshly obtain from anywhere. Outside, from anywhere means for all these three worlds. Na anavaptam avaptavyam, but still, vartayeva cha karmani, aham karmani eva varte. That is, I am constantly engaged in some action. That is for what? We heard this word, loka sangraha earlier. Loka sangraha. Where is that? Kuryad, we also saw that word, loka sangraha in the vyakhyana. So, loka sangraha, lokasya vanmarga pravritti nivaranam loka sangraha, we read. So, why is Krishna doing karma? He is doing karma for loka sangraha, for the public good. That is so that he will set an example before the world and all other people will emulate him. So, that is the reason why Krishna is engaged in karma. Otherwise, there is no reason for Krishna to engage in karma. So, let us see this shloka. Na me partha asti kartavyam trishu lokeshu kinchana. Na anavaptam is na plus anavaptam. Avaptam is something which is obtained. Anavaptam is something which is not obtained. Na plus anavaptam is there is a double negative. There is nothing which is not obtained. That means which is all things are in me only. And avaptavyam, that means which I have to obtain freshly, afresh. Varta eva. Varta is varte. Varte is atmanepadi dhatu. It is varte. But in shloka it becomes varta eva. In shloka when it is combining with another vowel, varta eva, varte eva, that becomes varta eva cha karmani. I am constantly engaged in action. So, in the last class, I was about to tell about this avatara. what is the meaning of avatara, and then I stopped there. Then Krishna is saying, why is Krishna saying name parthasti kartavyam? After all, everybody has some kartavyam, everybody has a bounden duty. But then of course we can see this at two levels. A jnani is somebody for whom there is no kartavyam. A person who has attained the brahmajnana is somebody who, for whom there is no kartavyam, there is nothing which he has to compulsorily do, because he is already somebody who has attained chitta shuddhi. And then whatever karma he does by virtue of this prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma is, he is born as some king, he is born in some other, with some social responsibility. So that social responsibility he has to execute. So that is, but still that karma does not affect him. It is not even nishkama karma, it is jnani karma. Nishkama karma is another slightly lower level. That is, nishkama karma is only leading to chitta shuddhi. We are now talking about jnani karma. Lord Krishna, we should not call him a seeker like you and me, who is doing some nishkama karma with the idea of having this chitta shuddhi. Lord Krishna is at a higher level, we should admit it. And then Lord Krishna is at the level of a jnani, where he does karma for loka sangraha. He knows that he is basically above all these things. In fact, jnani also, he is somebody who is a witness, he is sakshi rupena, he is looking at everything as a sakshi. But still he does all these things for loka sangraha. So when we see this shloka at two levels, one level is looking at Krishna as a jnani, the other is looking at Krishna as an avatar. We all know and we all accept that Lord Krishna was an avatar. Then what is an avatar? So from that I just wanted to say a couple of things. We have this concept of avatar. Avatara actually means avataranam. Avatarati in Sanskrit, the verb avatarati means getting down from somewhere. Yanat avatarati, he gets down from the vehicle. So akashat vrukshat avatarati, vrukshat markataha avatarati. If I say the monkey is getting down from the tree, so avataranam is getting down. So avatara is the process of getting down. Getting down means, in fact, the Puranic sages, it is an imagination of these Puranic sages, that God is there somewhere up in the heaven, and then he comes down in flesh and blood. In English we call it incarnation. In fact, the word incarnation also means carnal, is something relating to flesh. Carnal means something relating to flesh. And then incarnation is coming down in flesh and blood, appearing before us in flesh and blood. So that is incarnation. So avatara is something similar to that. So when we talk about these avataras, we have this so many avataras in our Puranas. What is this avataras? We have got this dashavataralu, and all these dashavataralu relate to Vishnu. Vishnu only. He is the god who is said to have descended in so many forms. Then of course, for Shiva, people say, talk about one avatara, that is Dakshinamurti avatara. Dakshinamurti is said to be a jnana avatara. Dakshinamurti, he descended or he appeared in the world only to spread the Brahma Jnana. So he is called Jnana Avatara. So that is one amsha. And I don't think Brahma and any other god has got any avataras. So in avataras again, the question is, what type of body he is having actually? We know that we are all born because of karma phalam. There is a karma phala, and because of that karma phala we are born. So there is what is called a sthola sharira, there is what is called a sukshma sharira, the subtle body. And after the fall of this body, the sukshma sharira goes into some other body. That is what we have seen in the second chapter also. Mahanyate hanyamane sharire, vasamsi jirnani yatha vihaya, navani grunhati naroparani. Like you discard old clothes and put on new clothes, this linga sharira is what transmigrates. This linga sharira discards this old decrepit body and takes up a new body. So that is what we have seen. So we know that in the case of all other beings, it is the linga sharira which is going and taking the new body because of the karma phala, because of the fruit of whatever action you have done. But in the case of God, in the case of that divine, cosmic being, whatever we say, where is the karma phala? There is no karma phala for him. Because he is not subject to all these karma phala rules. He is not like us, subject to karma phala rules. So that is called a body which has nothing to do with karma phala. The difference between we and this avatar purusha is that we are all our bodies. They are say appearing as a result of our karma phala. Whereas the avatara sharira is not depending on our karma phala, on any karma phala. So that is number one. That is called Ichha Sharira. Ichha Sharira means that is just depending on the cosmic will. So a person appears. Then in Vedanta Shastra, it is also mentioned by the Vedantins that this sort of avatara appears whenever there is adharma, whenever there is prevalence of adharma in society, so whenever there is a great disorder. So at that time, in fact, we are going to see in the fourth chapter, Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya, it is a very very familiar shloka, Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya Glanir Bhavati Bharata Abhyutthanam Adharmasya, whenever there is an ascendance of this adharma and whenever there is a, say, glani or some sort of danger to the extreme danger to the dharma. So at that time, this Lord appears. So what is the reason? So for example, in one book called Vichara Sagara is originally written about 150 years ago or maybe around that time by one Sadhu Nishchal Das of North India, and it is translated into Sanskrit by Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati. He is somebody who lived around 50 years ago or more. So this Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati's book, if somebody has, it is in page 125 of that book. So he explains what exactly is this tattva, avatara tattva. So he says that it is because of this sort of cosmic intelligence or cosmic being, it takes a particular form on earth because of the collective punya of all the good people who are suffering, and the collective papam, the collective or cumulative bad deeds of all the evil people. Then this avatara appears in order to eradicate the bad people and then establish dharma. So that is what it is only a Puranic concept, not a Vedanta concept, because this thing called avatara and all these things, they are at the transactional level only. It is not at the absolute level. Transactional level means this dharma which we are talking about, it is at two levels. We know that for all the loka vyavahara, for all the day-to-day transaction, we need some rules and regulations. We also need some system of punyam and papam. We also need some sort of belief system, let us say, about the existence of a particular god, about the existence of some particular type of swarga, and then existence of some other type of, narakam or some sort of hell, equivalent to something like hell, where you suffer. So things like that. So these are all in the realm of Vyavaharika Satya, that is in the realm of transactional reality and not in the realm of absolute reality. Absolute reality, when you reach that jnana stage, hell, heaven and all these things, they become irrelevant. Swarga also becomes irrelevant. So that is how we have to understand it. So this avatara is only because of Swam Mayam Vasikrutya. That is what Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati says. Swam Mayam Vasikrutya. Then he also quotes the introduction of Gita Bhashya, Swamayaya Dehavaniva. We have seen in this introduction of Gita Bhashya, in the very first few sentences, Swamayaya Dehavaniva Jatayivacha. So that is what Shankaracharya had said. Because we are talking about this Mayavachinna Chaitanyam, which is responsible for this entire creation. This Mayavachinna Chaitanyam is appearing as something on this earth in order to establish dharma. So that is the belief system, let us say, that is the system in which is also accepted in Vedanta as a second level of reality. There is a higher level of reality, there is a lower level of reality. At this level of reality, it is again accepted that this avatara is like this. It is something which is a body which is not due to this punya papa. It is an ichha sharira, number one. Then again, it is because of the collective punya of the good people and collective, collective evil deeds of all the bad people. Then there are two different types of avataras. One is an avatara which is for a short time, for a specific purpose. It is called Amsha, Amsha avatara. Amsha avatara is, for example, you know the story of Prahlada and Hiranyakashipu. And then the Hiranyakashipu's all bad deeds were there. And then the Lord appeared in order to remove that Hiranyakashipu. He came in that avatar of Narasimha Swami and then removed that man. So something like that, some other Vamana avatar. There is the story of Bali and Vamana. That again has to be taken symbolically. All these things have to be taken symbolically. So Hiranyakashipu, Hiranya means gold. Kashipu means a pillow. Pillow and also a mattress. So Hiranyakashipu is a fellow who sleeps on a golden mattress and a golden pillow. So that means a fellow who is only after wealth. So then such a man does not have Prahlada. Hlada means happiness. Prahlada is, he is because very very happy because he is a Brahmajnani. Hiranyakashipu's son is Prahlada, who is a Jnani. A person who is hankering after wealth, he cannot have Prahlada, he cannot have happiness. So naturally these two things are quarreling. So that is where the Lord has to intervene and see that greed and avarice have to be removed. So that is a symbol. Symbolically it has to be taken. Similarly Bali again, it is a question of when Vamana puts his foot on the head of Bali, it only means that removal of ahankara, that the feeling of I has to be removed. So that is the significance there if you read that Bali Vamana story. So anyway, these things are called Amsha avataras. That is only for a specific purpose the Lord appears. Then there are called Purna avataras. What is a Purna avatara? Purna avatara is something where there is a birth. For example, you take the story of Rama. We know right from the beginning how these rishis, they were doing some tapas. And how all these rishis were being tortured by the demons, and then how the Lord Vishnu promises to them that he would appear in, as the son of Dasharatha, and how he takes birth, and then how he grows, and how he is trained by sage Vishwamitra, and then how he goes into the forest. All this story is there, a whole full-fledged story from there till the birth, till the end of the avatar. Similarly, in the case of Krishna, you find the story right from the stage of birth till the end of the avatar. So you have a full-fledged story. This is there for sadhakas to emulate, to see his conduct, at every step. That is why we call Ramayana, Rama's path. Rama plus Ayanam, Ramayanam, Rama's path. That is Rama's way of life, how he lived. Ramo Vigrahavan Dharmaha, that's what Ramayanam says. That is, he was the embodiment of dharma. He was the whatever dharma is ordained in this world. So he was the embodiment of that. Similarly, Krishna. So these are full avataras, whose message is relevant for all times. Whereas in the case of an Amsha avatara, it is only for a specific purpose. It does not have so much of import for all people at all times. But this Purna avatara, it is a complete manifestation which is relevant for all people at all times. This is a question of a sort of exemplary life. And seekers, actually they do upasana on these things and then they can attain perfection. So these are the things which are noted in that Vichara Sagara by this Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati. So anyway, it does. And then one more thing which we have to see is that this, whenever this Lord appears on this earth, it does not mean that Vaikuntham falls vacant. This is another thing which our Puranics, they keep on saying. The Vaikuntham does not fall vacant. It is only that cosmic intelligence or cosmic power, one Amsha of that cosmic power comes like this and then does its job and then goes back. So that is how we have to take it. It is not as though Lakshmi Devi is pining for this gentleman, or Lakshmi Devi again takes birth here. Even that is okay. Even that also is told in both in Rama Avatara and Krishna Avatara. But then it is not as though that heaven falls vacant and all the people or all the subordinates there are waiting for him and all that. It is only a Puranic concept which has to be understood in a rather limited sense. Okay. So at that level also we can see this shloka when Lord Krishna says name parthasti kartavyam. Lord Krishna has no kartavyam because he is an amsha, he is a purna avatar. So okay, now let us see what let us see Shankaracharya's bhashyam. Name iti.
Name iti.
Name mama.
Name mama.
Partha.
Partha.
Nasti navidyate.
Nasti navidyate.
Kartavyam trishvapi lokeshu.
Kartavyam trishvapi lokeshu.
Kinchana kinchidapi.
Kinchana kinchidapi.
Kasmat.
Kasmat.
Na anavaptam.
Na anavaptam.
Avaptam. What is it? Na anavaptam. Apraptam.
Apraptam.
Avaptavyam.
Avaptavyam.
Prapaniyam.
Tathapi
vartayevacha
karmani aham.
Okay, so this is very simple say line. Na me, me is to me, mama. He partha, o partha, nasti means navidyate. Nothing, there is nothing which exists, it does not exist. What? Kartavyam, there is no bounden duty exists for me. Trishvapi lokeshu, in all the three worlds, we talk of the three worlds, Bhur, Bhuva, Suvaha, we talk of these three worlds, this Bhuloka, then Bhuvarloka, and then again Suvarloka, we talk about these three worlds. In all the three worlds, there is no duty for me, there is nothing which is a bounden duty for me. Kinchana, kinchidapi. Kinchana means of whatsoever, there is no duty whatsoever for me in all the three worlds. Then kasmat, kasmat means why? Na anavaptam apraptam. Anavaptam is apraptam, something which is not attained by me. Then avaptavyam, which has to be obtained by me, you know, yet. Tathapi varta eva cha karmani aham. Tathapi means even then I am engaged in action. So it is quite simple. So let us see the next shloka. We will read the shloka. Yadihyaham na varteya. Jātu karmanya tandritaha.
Jātu karmanya tandritaha.
Mama vartmānu vartante.
Mama vartmānu vartante.
Manushyāh pārtha sarvaśaha.
Manushyāh pārtha sarvaśaha.
Okay. Yadi hi aham. Yadi hyaham is yadi hi aham. Na varteya. Na varteya. The print, some books, there is a print mistake. Varteyam. It is not varteyam, but it is varteya. Yadi hyaham na varteya jatu karmani atandritaha. Karmani atandritaha is karmani atandritaha. Mama vartma anuvartante. Anuvartante manushyaha partha sarvashaha. The words are also simple. He means esmat, because. Yadi hi aham na varteya jatu karmani atandritaha. It means if I do not enthusiastically engage in action. Atandritaha means enthusiastically participating, enthusiastically taking up a work. Tandra means laziness. Tandra in Sanskrit is laziness. Tandritaha means somebody who is lazy. Atandritaha means somebody who is not lazy. Alasa, alasatvam, in Telugu we use the word alasa in a different way. Alasyam means we use it in the sense of delay. Sanskritam alasyam does not mean delay. In Telugu we use the word wrongly. Alasyam, alasyam ayindi we say. Alasyam means delay. But it is not the original meaning. Alasyam means actually for delay the word is vilambaha. Vilambas sanjataha we should say. Alasyam is laziness. Atandritaha means somebody who is not lazy. Because there can be a tendency when you are asked to do a nishkama karma. Then you are anyway nishkama karma, why should I do enthusiastically? It should not be done like that. So that is what Krishna says. If I do not engage myself in a very, very enthusiastic and active manner, in a brisk manner, mama vartmanu vartante manushyah partha sarvashaha. He partha, manushyah sarvashaha, people all over. Manushyah sarvashaha in all ways, in all matters. Mama vartma anuvartante. Mama vartma. Vartma means a path. My, say, lifestyle, let us say. Vartma actually means a path. Mama vartma anuvartante. They actually, they will follow my own path. They will follow my own lifestyle. If I am acting in a particular way, people also will say, okay. If Lord Krishna gives up all, duties, all the duties which are there, to be done by a grihastha. In fact, Lord Krishna, what is his position? Lord Krishna is born in a particular kingly family and he is also a family man. So as a king, he has to do some dharma. As a family man, he has got some dharma. So all these dharmas he has to execute. He may be a jnani, he may be the very avatara. In spite of all that, he has to execute all that. In fact, we know that Lord Krishna went to a school. As a jnani, he need not go to a school. A god need not go to a school. But then he went to a school. Who is that teacher? Sandipani. Sandipani. That is the name given to this Chinmaya school also. So this Sandipani is a teacher. And then who was his colleague? That Kuchela was his colleague there. Maybe there might have been many other colleagues, but Kuchela is one colleague whom we know, a co-student, Saha Vidyarthi. So like that, Krishna went through all that drill of reading, studying Veda with a teacher. And then he got married and then he was doing this grihastha dharma. All these things he has to do. If he does not do, then all other people also will not do. So that is the meaning here. Yadi hi aham na varteya. Na varteya means if I do not engage myself. That is varteya is in, it is called vidhiling in Sanskrit. Varteya, varteya, vartevahi, vartemahi. So that is, if I do not, in case I do not. So that is the meaning. Yadi hi aham na varteya na jatu. Jatu we know. Jatu means kadachit. Kadachit means at any time. Jatu means at any time. If I at any time do not engage myself in action. So that is the overall meaning. If at any time na jatu means at any time if I do not engage myself in action. In what? In karmani. Karmani means in action. In what manner? Atandritaha. In a very enthusiastic manner. I have to do karma with a very great eagerness and enthusiasm. If I do not do that, mama vartma anuvartante manushyaha partha sarvasha. People all over, in all matters, they will follow me. They will imitate me. And then they will also give up duties. So that is the message. In fact, Krishna, as I said, he also went to Gurukulam. The message is that everyone has to do his dharma. In fact, we talk about, say this deterioration of dharma. And again, we blame others. Okay, this is all Western influence which has come to us. And because of the Western influence, we are all, suffering. So that is what we unnecessarily blame other people. But we have ourselves given up. Western influence may be there. Influence is bound to be there. Social change is something which is bound to be there. In fact, when technology grows, technology results in social change. When there is social change, there is some impact on the so-called institutions like religion, family and all these things. So these social institutions, we also should know how to cope with that social change. If we do not cope with the social change and if we say that this social change has overtaken us and then, oh, you cannot do your Sandhyavandan, you cannot read Gita. So, which means you are only blaming somebody else for our own inaction. It does not, simply because a person is somebody working in a software field or somebody who is doing some other thing, it does not mean that he is not even having half an hour sometime in the night or sometime in the early morning to read Gita. So, they say we need not, we cannot blame others. And then hold everything responsible on them. So in fact, the ability to cope with the change, that is what is required. And inability to cope with the change is what results in this deterioration. In fact, I was referring to one book called The Future Shock. Future Shock, which is a book written by a sociologist about 40 years ago. It talks about the inability of the social institutions to cope with the social change. And because of this inability, that inability itself is called the future shock. And we feel that all our institutions have collapsed because of the social change. It is not the mistake of the social change. Change is bound to happen because of so many technological advancements and so many things which are taking place in society. And we should know how to cope with that. We should know how to stick to our dharma. We need not do all our yajnas and whatnot, all those things we may not be able to do. But at least whatever is the basic minimum, we should be able to do. So that is the overall purport of this shloka. Let us see what Shankaracharya is saying. Yadihi punaha अहम् न वर्तेय जातु कदाचित् कर्मणि अतन्द्रितः अनलसः अनलसः सन् मम श्रेष्ठस्य सतः वर्त्मा मार्गम् अनुवर्तन्ते मनुष्याः हे पार्थ सर्वशः सर्वप्रकारैः హే పార్థ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది అడ్రస్ సర్వశః సర్వప్రకారై దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ఆల్ మ్యాటర్స్ అండ్ ఇన్ ఆల్ వేస్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ యది హి పునః హీ మీన్స్ యస్మాత్ అహం న వర్తేయ ఇఫ్ ఐ డు నాట్ ఎంగేజ్ ఇన్ యాక్షన్ జాతు మీన్స్ కదాచిత్ అట్ ఎనీ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ కర్మణి ఇన్ యాక్షన్ అతంద్రిత అనలస దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ఎ వెరీ ఎంతూజియాస్టిక్ మేనర్ అనలస సమ్ ఇన్ ఎన్ ఎంతూజియాస్టిక్ మేనర్ మమ శ్రేష్టస్య సతః బికాస్ ఐ ఆమ్ సంబడీ హూ ఈజ్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ హై ఎస్టీమ్ ఇన్ సొసైటీ శ్రేష్ఠ హూ ఈజ్ శ్రేష్ఠ శ్రేష్ఠ ఈజ్ సంబడీ హూ ఈజ్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ హై ఎస్టీమ్ ఇన్ సొసైటీ శ్రేష్ఠ ఇన్ఫ్యాక్ట్ ద వర్డ్ శ్రేష్ఠి ఈజ్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ ఓన్లీ శ్రేష్ఠి వీ కాల్ హిమ్ శెట్టి శ్రేష్ఠి ఈజ్ సంబడీ హూ ఈజ్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ హై ఎస్టీమ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ వెల్త్ అండ్ వాట్ నాట్ సో హియర్ దట్ నాట్ వీఆర్ నాట్ రెఫరింగ్ టు దట్ శ్రేష్ఠి వీఆర్ రెఫరింగ్ టు సంబడీ హూ ఈజ్ ఏ నోబుల్ మ్యాన్ ఇన్ సొసైటీ మమ శ్రేష్టస్య సతః బికాస్ ఐ ఆమ్ ఐ బిలాంగ్ టు దట్ సే లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ సే దట్ శ్రేష్ట మమ వర్త్మ వర్త్మ ఈజ్ మార్గం మార్గం ఈజ్ పాత్ మై వే ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ అనువర్తంతే దే ఇమిటేట్ దే ఫాలో మనుష్యాః సర్వశః సో ఇట్ ఈస్ క్వైట్ సింపుల్ సో విల్ సీ ద నెక్స్ట్ శ్లోక సో ది బేసిక్ ఐడియా ఆఫ్ దిస్ శ్లోక ఈజ్ దట్ ఎనీబడీ హూ ఈజ్ ఎ కర్మాధికారి కర్మాధికారి ఈజ్ ఎనీబడీ హూ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ఎ బౌండెడ్ డ్యూటీ ఏ గృహస్థ హ్యాజ్ ఎ బౌండెడ్ డ్యూటీ ఏ బ్రహ్మచారి హ్యాజ్ ఎ బౌండెడ్ డ్యూటీ ఏ వానప్రస్థ హ్యాజ్ ఎ బౌండెడ్ డ్యూటీ సో ఎనీబడీ ఇన్ ఎ పర్టిక్యులర్ ఆశ్రమ అండ్ హూ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ బౌండెడ్ డ్యూటీ హీ హ్యాస్ టు డూ దట్ ధర్మ సో దట్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ ఎ జ్ఞాని హీ హ్యాస్ టు డూ ఇట్ ఫర్ లోక సంగ్రహ ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ ఎ సీకర్ ఆర్ ఇఫ్ ఈజ్ అన్ ఆర్డినరీ మ్యాన్ హీ షుడ్ డూ ఎ నిష్కామ కర్మ You and I, it is recommended for us that Nishkama Karma is recommended. If it is a Jnani, then he will be doing for Loka Sangraha. So that is the main point we have to see. So we will see the next shloka. Tathacha, ko doshaha ityaha. Okay, if so, what happens? That is the meaning. Tathacha, ko doshaha, what is wrong? Ko doshaha means what is wrong? If that is so, what is wrong? So that is what is they go saying in the next class, next shloka. Utside yurime lokaha nakuryam karma chedaham sankarasya cha kartasyam upahanyami mah prajaha. So if you assume that I need not do any action, I need not do anything, then I will be contributing to the collapse of this system. So that is what Krishna says here. If I do not do my job, if I do not do my duty, I will be contributing to the collapse, the total breakdown of this system, of this universe, this mama vartma, because the loka will only imitate me. So that is why if I do not do, then there will be a sort of confusion. There will be sort of, total, the things will become topsy-turvy and I will be contributing to the total collapse of this dharma. So that is the meaning here. Utsideyuhu ime loka. Utsideyu rime loka is utsideyuhu plus ime. Ime loka means these lokas. What are these lokas? He referred to these three lokas, bhurbhuvasavaha, three lokas he referred. And three lokas refer to three different types of sadhakas. In fact, even in Swarga, they are there, but then they have not attained moksha. So that is why bhuhu, bhuvaha, suvaha, they are all at one level only. A slightly difference in grade, but then they are not already jnanis. So in these three levels, the ime lokaha, these three lokas, utsideyuhu, sidati, ut plus sidati. Sidati means sits. Utsideyu means it becomes topsy-turvy. They become, totally... Utsideyuhu, they become rather disturbed. They get highly, utsideyu, is there any other word, any better word? No. Utsideyu, the literal meaning is, they become topsy-turvy. they become totally confused. Utsideyuhu ime lokaha na kuryam karma chedaham. If I do not do karma. Nashinchukunde, they get destroyed. Yeah, destroyed. Utsideyuhu, actually, literally it means it gets topsy-turvy, it gets totally, dysfunctional, let us say. So, utsideyuhu ime lokaha na kuryam karma chedaham. If I do not do karma, these lokas are going to be topsy-turvy, these lokas are going to be destroyed. Then, sankarasya cha karta syam. Aham, sankarasya cha karta syam. I will be called or I will become the karta of sankara. I will be doing this sankara. What is this sankara? Sankara means mixing up, confusion. So somebody does some duty, somebody does somebody else's duty, somebody is doing something else. So there is a confusion of duties, things will not be in a proper way. So that is the meaning. Sankarasya cha karta syam. Upahanyam means I will be destroying. I will be contributing to the collapse. I will be contributing to the destruction of all these people. Upahanyam imaha prajaha. Imaha prajaha means all these people, all these beings in the universe, I will be actually destroying. That is the meaning. So the words are also simple. Utsideyuhu ime lokaha na kuryam karma chet aham. Chet plus aham chedaham. So chet is a conditional. Aham na kuryam chet. That is, if I do not do karma, that is the meaning. Aham sankarasya cha karta syam. I will be the karta of this sankara, this dharma sankara. Somebody doing somebody else's job and then be confusion about duties. Then upahanyam imah prajaha. I will be destroying all the people. So if I do not do karma, that is what is going to happen. That is it. So let us see. Utsideyuhu. Vinashyeyuhu ime sarve lokaha lokasthiti nimittasya karmanaha abhavat na kuryam karma chedaham. Okay, he says utsideyuhu vinashyeyuhu, they will perish. Vinasha is perishing. Vinashyeyuhu means they will perish. Utsideyuhu, they will perish. Ime sarve lokaha. All these words. Why? Lokasthiti nimittasya karmanaha abhavat. Karma is responsible for this lokasthiti. Karma or action is responsible for the maintenance. Lokasthiti means for the existence, for the stability. For the stability of this loka, for the stability of this world. This karma. Karma means not the ordinary karma which we do, but whatever is ordained according to a person's status in society, that bounden duty a person has to do. So if he does not do that, this lokasthiti will collapse. Lokasthiti nimittasya karmanaha abhavat vinashyeyuhu. If I do not do karma, all these lokas will perish because of the absence of karma which is required for the stability of the world. So that is the meaning. Karmanaha abhavat. Abhavat means absence. Absence of this karma. Na kuryam karma chedaham. If I do not do karma. Kincha. Moreover, kincha means, we'll read. Kincha. Sankarasya.
Sankarasya.
Cha karta syam. Tena karanena upahanyam imah prajaha prajanam anugrahaya prajanam anugrahaya pravruttaha upahitam upahatim upahananam upahatim upahananam kuryam ityartha okay kincha moreover sankarasya cha kartasyam. I will be becoming the karta. I will be the doer of this sankara. I will be held responsible for this confusion. I will be responsible for this mixing up of duties. Tena karanena, because of that, upahanyam imah prajaha. Imah prajaha means these people. Upahanyam prajaha prajanam anugrahaya pravruttaha upahitam upahatim upahananam kuryam. You see, prajanam upa anugrahaya pravruttaha. I have come down here. Only for praja anugraha, in order to uplift people, in order to help people, in order to establish dharma. Prajanam anugraha. Anugraha means we know. Anugraha is compassion. I have come down because of compassion. Anugraha, anugraha bhashanam. Some Swamiji gives anugraha bhashanam. What is anugraha bhashanam? He just spreads his knowledge. It is called out of sheer compassion for the humanity. So like that, Prajanam Anugrahaya Pravurtaha. I am here only for the welfare of humanity. And then instead of doing that, on the other hand, I will be contributing to their downfall. I will be contributing to their degradation. So that is the meaning here. Upahatim, Upahananam. Upahananam is destruction. Upahananam. Hanadhatu means beating. Hanadhatu also means destroy. Upahananam is destroying. I will be contributing to the destruction, or in fact, whatever action I am doing will be detrimental to them, let us say. So it will be detrimental to their, say the existence of society. In fact, say this behavior of a top man is imitated by all others. This is what this Taittiriya Upanishad also says. I think I told this line once. Atha yadite dharma vichikitsava vritta vichikitsava syat. If you have any doubt about any dharma or about your conduct, dharma is a higher level. Vritta is a normal code of conduct, normal behavior. So atha yadite dharma vichikitsava vritta vichikitsava syat, then yetatra brahmana sammarshinaha yukta ayuktaha. You have to see what the learned people of that area do. Suppose you are here, you go to North India. And then you do not know the local habits, local customs and what not. Then you have to see how the elders behave there, how the learned people behave there. Of course, we have to imagine the olden days. In olden days, now of course there is a communication and we know there is so much of uniformity brought about by technology and also by the media. Here a person in Hyderabad does not differ from some person in Delhi. But then in olden days, there was so much of gap, there was so much of lack of communication. So that is why they said, if you are there in a new place and if there is any doubt about what is the dharma and what is the vritta about the conduct, then you please see the, say, conduct, code of conduct of the, say, learned people there, and whatever they say, that becomes the standard for you. So that is how it says. So these are the points which we have to, say, see here. So next shloka, upahananam kuryam ityartha. Oh, there is one more line. Mama Ishwarasya
ananurupam apadyeta
yadi punaha
ahamiva tvam
kurtartha buddhihi atmavid anyova tasyapi atmanah kartavya bhavepi paranugraha eva kartavya iti. Yes. So mama ishvarasya ananurupam apadyata. So you see, earlier he said, I have come down only for the welfare of the people. But if I act something in a way detrimental to the welfare of the people, it is something unbecoming of me. Ananurupam. Ananurupam is, that is something not in conformity with my nature. Na plus anurupam, ananurupam, that is not in conformity with my duty, not in conformity with my, say, mandate. Ananurupam eva apadyeta, it will become something which is not in accordance with my own nature, not in accordance with my own dharma. So mama ishvarasya ananurupam apadyeta. The Lord actually is supposed to protect. Lord is not supposed to confuse. So that is what he says. Yadi punaha ahameva tvam kurtartha buddhihi. Like me, you also feel that you are a Kritartha. Kritartha buddhi, he means one who feels that he is a Kritartha, one who feels that he is a Jnani. Tvamapi Kritartha buddhi, Atmavid anyova, or anybody else who is an Atmavid, anybody else who is a Jnani. Tathapi Atmanaha Kartavya Bhavepi, even then, Tathapi means even then. Atmanaha Kartavya Bhavepi, though he has nothing to do. Atmanaha Kartavya Abhava. Kartavya Abhava means there is no bounden duty for that man. Abhava means absence. Though there is absence of any bounden duty for him, Kartavya Abhava, absence of bounden duty for him, even then, Paranugraha eva Kartavya iti. Paranugraha means, like he said, Lokanugraham. In order to help others, in order to set a model for before others, in order to set himself as a role model for others, so he has to do karma. So that is the meaning here. Next line, Saktaha iti. Let us read this shloka. saktah karmanya vidvamsah yatha kurvanti bharata kuryad vidvanstatha saktah chikirshur lokasangraham. So this is a wonderful shloka which is quite often quoted by our Shringeri Swamiji also. Saktah karma, in fact several times I have seen him quoting this shloka. Saktah karmani avidvamsaha yatha kurvanti bharata. So the overall meaning is like this. The avidvamsaha, avidvamsaha means the ignorant people. Vidvamsaha is ignorant, knowledgeable people. Vidvamsaha is not singular, vidvamsaha is plural. In Telugu, we say vidvamsa. Vidvamsa means you refer to a single man. But Sanskritam, it is not like that. Vidvan is singular, vidvamsaha is plural. Vidvan, vidvamsav, vidvamsaha. So, avidvamsaha is na plus vidvamsaha, avidvamsaha, that is ignorant people. Ignorant people, they do action. They do action like what? With a karma phala asakti and what not. With the ignorant people, they do karma with karma phala asakti. I do yaga, I want this some punya, I want some more wealth, I want some more prosperity, I want some other thing. So all these things they do. Then they do with a great vigor, they do with a great enthusiasm, and they do with all dedication. So just as the ignorant people do karma with all dedication and with all eagerness, vidwan, that is a wise man, he has to do with equal dedication, with equal briskness, with equal alacrity. Chikirshuhu lokasangraham. For what? Lokasangraham chikirshuhu. In order to ensure welfare of this world, chikirsha means kartum icha. Chikirshuhu lokasangraham means lokasangraham kartum icha. Lokasangraha chikirsha. That is, with a desire to do lokasangraha, one has to do, a wise man has to do karma. With the same amount of alacrity, with the same degree of dedication and eagerness and enthusiasm. So that is the meaning here. Saktaha karmani plus avidvamsaha. Karmani avidvamsaha has to break as karmani plus avidvamsaha. Yatha kurvanti bharata kuryat vidvan statha saktaha. It is only one line. Kuryat vidvan plus tatha. Vidvans, it becomes vidvans tatha. Asaktaha. Asaktaha means not interested in the fruit of action. Sakti is desire. Asakti is lack of desire. That is, not desiring the fruit of the action. Vidwan anyway, the jnani, he is not having that, he has gone beyond that level. Asaktaha. Chikirshuhu lokasangraham. Chikirshuhu means desiring to do. Chikirshu is desiring to do lokasangraham, that welfare of humanity. So that is the meaning here. Let us read Bhashyam. Saktaha karmani
asya karmanah phalam
mama bhavishyati iti kechid avidvamsah yatha kurvanti
bharata
kuryad vidvan
atmavit
tatha asaktas san. Okay, the same thing. Saktaha karmani. Karmani means in karma. Saktaha, that is desirous of the fruit of that action, who are coveting that fruit of that action. Saktaha karmani asya karmanah phalam mama bhavishyati. Yes, I am going to get this karma phala. Asya karmanah phalam mama bhavishyati means I am going to get this karma phala. That is, with that idea in mind. Kechid avidvamsaha. Kechid means some people. Avidvamsaha, the ignorant people. That is, those who are not enlightened. The shloka is talking about the difference in karma of an enlightened man and an unenlightened man. An enlightened man also does karma with a lot of eagerness and with an intention that he is going to get karma phala. But an enlightened man, he does with the same amount of eagerness, but with an awareness that he is not going to get karma phala, he is above all that, he is doing it as a sakshi. That is the difference. So, kuryat vidvan, karma phalam mama bhavishyati iti kechit avidvamsaha yatha kurvanti bharata, he bharata. Bharata is, we know, I explained several times, yatha kurvanti, just as they do, kuryat vidvan atmavit. Kuryat means he will do. Kuryat is a vidhiling. He will do like that. Vidvan. Vidvan means a jnani. Atmavit. That is one who has knowledge of this Atman. Asaktaha san. That is by being, asakta. Asakta is somebody who is not interested in, who is not having attachment. Not having, not interested, not having attachment. Sakti is attachment. Asakti is non-attachment. Asakta is without that karma phala visandhi, without that desire to get this karma phala. So that is the meaning here. Tadvat
kimartham karoti
tat shrunu
chikirshuhu yatha kartum ichchuhu
lokasangraham. Tadartham kimartham karoti. That tadvat kimartham karoti. Tadvat means like that. Tadvat kimartham karoti. Why does he do like that? Tat shrunu. Listen. Tat shrunu means you listen. Hindi suno. Chikirshuhu yatha kartum ichchuhu. Chikirshuhu means who is desirous of doing what? Lokasangraham. Lokasangraham has been explained earlier. So next shloka. So this shloka basically talks about sakta karmanya vidvamsa, all karmas are in this ajnani dasha. We have seen that all karmas are in the ajnani dasha. And then they are, but then it does not mean prohibited karma. They are all doing shastriya karma only. They are all doing karma which is permitted by the Vedas. But then they are doing it in a particular way. The vidwan also does the same karmas in a totally different way. That is the difference. Then next shloka. Evam lokasangraham chikirshoho.
Evam lokasangraham chikirshoho.
Na mama atmavidaha. Kartavyam asti. Anyasyava. Lokasangraham muktva. Tataha. Tasya atmavidaha. Idam upadishyate. So evam lokasangraham chikirshoho. Evam means in this manner. While trying to do this lokasangraha, while acting for the benefit of humanity, lokasangraham chikirshoho, while desiring to do action for lokasangraha, then na mama atmavidaha kartavyamasti. For me who am an atmavit, for me who am a jnani, na mama kartavyamasti. There is no kartavyam, there is no bounden duty for me. Then anyasyava means or for any other person who is a jnani. Or any other person means who is also a jnani. Anyasyeva kartavyam asti lokasangraham muktva. Muktva means except lokasangraha, there is no other reason. Except lokasangraha, there is no other reason why I should be engaged in action. Then tataha tasya atmavidaha idam upadishyate. Tataha means therefore, hence. Tasya atmavidaha, for such a person who is an atmavit, for such a person who is a jnani, then something more is being told. Of course, a jnani is doing something, he is doing some action, but then something more is being told to the same jnani about how he has to conduct himself, and then how he should not confuse others. So that is the meaning here. So let us read this shloka. I think today we have read three, four shlokas. I think it is very quite fast. Na buddhi bhedam janayet.
Na buddhi bhedam janayet.
Ajnanam karma sanginam. Joshayet sarva karmani.
Vidvan yuktas samacharan.
Okay. So this shloka is a wonderful shloka. Na buddhi bhedam janayet ajnanam karma sanginam. Suppose you see a jnani, and this jnani, he is somebody who is in a higher stage, and then he goes to somebody else who is doing his normal karma, a grihastha, he is doing some normal karma. So he is, while doing some puja, I am giving this to you, then this jnani goes and says, Are who are you to give, who is he to receive, there is nothing like that. This is all rubbish. Or somebody, that man says, I am doing pradakshina papoham papa karma ham papatma papa sambhava. He says, no, you are not a papi, you are a nitya shuddha buddha mukta swabhava. So something like that, you go and confuse him, and then you say all these things are at a lower stage, all that, all these things are the level of ignorance. Sometimes we do like that, because we ourselves, we feel that after reading some little bit of Gita, we tend to feel that we have become highly spiritual. Sometimes it happens to us. If we examine ourselves, it happens to us, because we read Gita and then we feel that we have achieved some jnana, and then there is no need for all this karma, there is no need for sandhyavandana, there is no need for any other thing. And then you go to and tell somebody, you need not go to a temple, you need not do puja, you need not do any sort of offering. So that is what we may tend to do. And then that man also, he will say, okay, he will also, if he gives up, then that is like that, somebody else also gives up, like that the whole society gives up. So that is what is likely to happen. So that should not be done. So that is the meaning of, that is the message of this shloka. Na buddhi bhedam janayet ajnanam karma sanginam. Karma sanginam. That is for those who are engaged in karma. Karma sangha. Sangha means what? Attachment, association. Karma sanginam, for those who are having association with karma, who are deeply interested in karma, and those who are engaged in karma means shastriya karma only. We are not talking about nishiddha karma. We are not talking about prohibited karma. So for all those people, na buddhi bhedam janayet, we should not unnecessarily perplex them. 4 minutes. So I will tell the overall meaning, and then we will see the bhashya in the next class. Na buddhi bhedam janayet. Buddhi bhedam is your mind is going in a particular direction. Bhedam, in Sanskrit, the word bhedam means to break. Mitra bhedam. So there is a breaking of friendship. So mitra bheda actually means breaking of friendship. Buddhi bhedam means breaking of your buddhi. So you are unnecessarily breaking his buddhi. His buddhi is going in a particular direction. He is a sincere man, no doubt. He is a God-fearing, sincere, ritualistic man. And you are going and unnecessarily trying to enlighten him. So the question arises, should we not teach Vedanta? Should I not teach some good thing to him? Should I not teach about Nishkama Karma? It has to be taught in a very, very careful and slow manner. So that is the meaning. We should be ourselves very, very perfect. A jnani is somebody, I give the example of this ladder. He goes up the ladder by climbing so many steps. And then by climbing to that stage, he should not say this ladder is bad, this ladder is meaningless and silly and whatnot. So he should also respect that ladder. He should also say, yes, you are on that first step, you are on the second step, you are on some other step. He should tell these sadhakas. And then depending on their ability, he has to teach them. So that is why Vedanta was not told to people in olden days. Vedanta was not told to everybody in olden days. Maybe, now in the present context, if we see, maybe that has done some damage also to us, because we have not told the essential concepts and we have only told the rituals. So there is some danger also here. You see, our Siddhanta was, Vedanta should not be taught to each and everybody unless there is a particular level of spiritual discipline. In fact, there is a book called Vedanta Sara. That is by, what is that gentleman? Sadananda, Vedanta Sara. So he says there is a definition of who is an adhikari. Adhikari means the person who is entitled to study Vedanta. So there he says, there is a long definition which I forget. Adhikari tu vidhivat adhita veda vedangatvena. That is vidhivat adhita veda vedangatvena. He has to go to a school. He has to do shushrusha to a teacher. And then he has to study Vedas. He has to study Vedangas. What he has to do, then again nitya karma, prayaschitta karma, upasana, all these things, anusthanena, nitanta nirmala swantaha. So his mind has to become tranquil, nitanta, completely, nirmala swantaha. He has to become such a swantahkarana, that a perfect antahkarana. Then sadhana chatushtaya sampannaha pramata. In between I forgot some lines. Sadhana chatushtaya sampanna means somebody who has attained that sadhana chetushtaya, that fourfold path of self-discipline, he must have done all that. So till that time, Vedanta was not told. In fact, even here, Madhusudana Saraswati gives an example. Agnyasya ardha prabuddhasya sarvam brahmeti yo vadet. So this Madhusudana Vyakya under this shloka is quite interesting. Agnyasya ardha prabuddhasya sarvam brahmeti yo vadet maha niraya jaleshu satena viniyojasaha. Suppose some half-baked intellectual, or some half-baked jnani goes and says, so you are a Brahma, you need not do anything. Ajnasya, to somebody who is an ajnani. Ardha prabuddhasya, who is having some half-baked knowledge. To that man, sarvam brahmeti yovadet. Suppose somebody, some jnani goes and tells him, this is all Brahman, sarvam brahma, all this karma is meaningless, it is all rubbish. Somebody goes, says like that. Maha nirayajaleshu satena viniyojitaha. You are pushing them into great delusion. You are pushing him into great problem. That fellow is neither here nor there. So that is the position. So that is what this, we don't know where this sloka is from. Where, but Madhusudana Saraswati in his commentary, he has quoted this sloka. So anyway, so this sort of confusion should not be created by anybody. That is the meaning of this overall thing is, na buddhi bhedam janayet ajnanam karma sanginam. Somebody is doing something, so let him do. Joshayet sarva karmani. Joshayet. You know the Hindi word josh. Josh is what? Josh dena, enthusiast. Just pat him on the back. Just give a pat on the back. Not a kick, but then a pat on the back. Joshayet. You encourage him. You say, okay, fine. You do that. You do that sincerely. Joshayet sarva karmani. Sarva karmani. All those approved actions, these are all, we are talking about approved actions only, all these approved actions, joshayet, you have to encourage, you have to give a pat on the back, vidwan yuktaha samacharan. But at the same time, this vidwan, this jnani also, he is also doing all those things, he is also doing, to all pretending to do, maybe not exactly pretending to be, but then he is doing as a sakshi, with all that sakshi bhava. So, keeping himself above all those things, but he does for Loka Sangraha. Vidwan Yuktaha. Yuktaha means Yoga Yuktaha. Here, of course, it is not Karma Yoga, it is Jnana Yoga. He is settled in that Atma Swarupa. His idea of that Brahman is quite firm. He is firmly settled in the idea of Brahman. And then with that position, that is called Yukta. Yukta means somebody who is well settled, yoked, let us say. Somebody who is yoked means yoked in the knowledge of Brahman. He is settled in that knowledge of Brahman. So he does this karma. Samacharan, that is samyak acharan. Sam plus acharan, samyak acharan. He also does all those things equally enthusiastically. And he does not unnecessarily confuse that man by telling certain things which will be again detrimental to the general public. So that is the overall meaning. Is the time over?
Yes.
Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.